What are all the nutrient deficiencies that cause hair loss? If you're experiencing hair loss and you're wondering if nutrients, vitamins, minerals, and your diet has a role in the thinning of your hair, or maybe your receding hairline and the cause of your hair fall overall, you've come to the right video. I'm gonna go over every nutrient that is relevant to this discussion by looking at the scientific literature and letting you know which ones to look out for if you're trying to restore your hair, so stay with me till the end. Also guys, share this video if you know someone who is going through hair loss, and give this video a like down below too. It takes 2 seconds. And as always, I'll try to be as thorough and helpful as I can. I'll also be sharing a bonus tip at the end, which can definitely be a game changer too. So of course there are multiple causes of hair loss, and nutrition alone isn't gonna be the answer for everyone. Why? Because everyone's hair loss is different, each with their own unique causes and backgrounds. And the medical term for hair loss is called alopecia, and we can break alopecia down into two types: scarring versus non-scarring alopecia. And the role of nutrients, minerals, and trace elements from our food and diet are really going to benefit the non-scarring types of alopecia, which for the most part is the reversible form of hair loss. And that's what we are going to tackle. So if you experience telogen effluvium, which to put it simply is hair loss from stress, or let's say androgenetic alopecia, which is the most common type of hair loss in men and women, this video should be useful to you. And to zoom in even more, for men, if the hair loss is in the vertex, bitemporal, and midfrontal scalp regions, and for women, if it's throughout the central scalp, these are going to be nutrients to keep tabs on and maintain, so that you can get a steady supply of them to support optimal hair regrowth. Now, whether that is going to be from food sources, or if you're looking for a supplement, then the Advanced Nutrients by Thorn is going to contain all the nutrients your scalp needs for regrowth, which you can find linked in the description below. You most certainly can go with both routes, diet or supplements. And with that said, let's begin by starting with the first one, being our vitamin A. And I'll try to be brief and straight to the point as best as I can. So with vitamin A, guys, the reason we need it is to help produce an optimal amount of sebum, not too much and not too little. Sebum is that oily substance that all scalps have that moisturizes it and keeps the hairs healthy. It also is involved in cell growth, which is crucial for renewal of hair follicles and the strength of the actual hair strand. Now, am I worried about vitamin A deficiency? Not really, since most of us are getting it from a balanced diet. So let's move on to the next one, vitamin B. Now, there are 8 different B vitamins, but there's only 4 types of vitamin B that actually matter for hair growth. Which ones are they? Riboflavin, biotin, folate, and vitamin B12, because deficiencies in these 4 B vitamins have been associated with hair loss from the studies. We can make an argument that these B vitamins are relevant to the discussion of hair regrowth. Another reason why I like the Advanced Nutrient Supplement from Thorn is that it includes all 4 B vitamins in the right ranges for hair growth. Now, as far as riboflavin goes, which is our vitamin B2, it's going to ensure that the cells in the hair follicle receive adequate energy and nutrients. As far as biotin, which I'm sure you've heard of, this is our vitamin B7. It supports the production of keratin, which is a key protein that makes up our hair. It also maintains the strength and the resilience of the actual hair strands and promotes growth. An adequate biotin level can improve hair thickness and shine, and a deficiency, which I'm not too worried about, although it is rare, can happen, which I explained here in this video, can lead to hair thinning, brittleness, and even hair loss for some folks. The third B vitamin, which is our folate or vitamin B9, is essential for hair health because it helps produce red blood cells. These are going to be the red blood cells which carry the oxygen and nutrients to the hair follicles. Also, folate regenerates these follicles, which is super important for regrowth issues. And the last B vitamin, which is our B12, this is involved in the formation of DNA and RNA, which is essential for hair renewal. Also, guys, a vitamin B12 deficiency leads to hair thinning, slower hair growth, and premature graying too, which shows us that vitamin B12 does play a role in hair cells. So that sums up our vitamin A and our vitamin Bs. Now let's move on to the next group of nutrients, which is vitamin C. Now, vitamin C plays a huge role indirectly, and let me explain. The vitamin C itself isn't going to go straight to your scalp. What it does is 2 things. It plays a key role in the production of collagen, which is a protein that helps strengthen the hair and give hair the architecture. And 2, it helps in the absorption of iron, which is gonna deliver the oxygen to the hair follicle. So definitely a deficiency in vitamin C can lead to weak, brittle hair and increased hair breakage because you aren't supporting both iron and collagen production. And I'm sure you can guess what the next nutrient would be. We covered A, B, C, and now we are on D. How does vitamin D, which we mentioned in these videos, play a role on hair? Well, it has an immunomodulatory effect. And what do I mean? It helps promote an optimal immune response by keeping inflammation balanced. Its anti-inflammatory properties help decrease levels of cytokines, which are proteins that mediate and regulate immunity and inflammation, right? High levels of inflammatory cytokines can contribute to the destruction of hair follicles. And vitamin D keeps this balance in check and makes sure that immune system doesn't attack the hair follicle, like we see in cases of alopecia areata. We even have a cross-sectional study conducted by Gade et al., which showed us that the mean vitamin D level was found to be significantly lower in patients with androgenetic alopecia than in healthy controls. In other words, individuals who had lower vitamin D levels were the ones seen to have alopecia areata. Now, correlation doesn't mean causation, but it is something to keep note of. Moving along, we have selenium. Now, one of our most important proteins in the body, being glutathione, needs selenium, which is going to be the master antioxidant, right? In fact, we have 35 proteins in the body that need selenium for them to work. More specifically, in hair cells, it contributes to the normal cycling of hair follicles. What I mean by that is that it supports the transition from the resting phase, which is telogen, to the growth phase, which is anagen, ensuring continuous and healthy hair growth keeps occurring. What was also interesting is that the literature showed us that a clinical trial in patients with ovarian cancer undergoing chemotherapy showed a significant decrease in hair loss, which I think is huge here. And other gastrointestinal symptoms in patients receiving selenium supplementation as compared with controls. So definitely we can see a connection between selenium and hair. And lastly, we have zinc. Where zinc comes to play is that it can reduce inflammation and control microbial growth on the scalp. This is huge because it's going to help seborrheic dermatitis and support a healthy scalp environment to make hair growth and regrowth more conducive. Because you can think of the scalp as a soil, and with good soil comes good growth. Now, interestingly, a zinc deficiency can occur in people who consume a large amount of cereal grain, which can contain phytate, considered to be a chelating agent of zinc. So keep that in mind. Now, all of these trace elements are going to be integral to maintaining healthy hair by supporting cellular functions necessary for hair growth. And of course, deficiencies in any of them are going to be areas that we can focus on, because once we restore them, we can rule out the nutritional cause of our hair loss and focus on the other causes that are in our control as well, like managing stress levels, fixing our hair care products by avoiding tight hairstyles and improving our sleep quality, quitting smoking and limiting alcohol, for example. Also, staying hydrated and improving our hair washing technique are others to name as well. Because at the end of the day, we want to ensure robust protein synthesis for strong, healthy hair. We want to regulate an optimal immune response to stop autoimmune hair loss. And we want the best scalp environment. Nutrients are one of the best places to start, in my opinion. Now, this is not to say you need a supplement to do all this. You can most certainly do this with a balanced diet. But if you want it in a more convenient way that is high quality, again, Thorne's Advanced Nutrients provides the right amount of every single one of these nutrients. The bonus tip here is supplementing with astaxanthin, because it also helps reduce the effects of aging hair, like hair fall, breakage, bald patches, and graying as you're trying to restore your hair back. But the Advanced Nutrient supplement includes the astaxanthin as well, so you can get it all in one bottle. And of course, not to forget to mention, with Thorne, you are getting professional grade supplements that are third-party tested, and most importantly, clean. And that's a huge thing. The link below is an affiliate link, so if you wanted to go the supplement route, you most certainly can down below. It also helps support the channel too, so I can continue bringing you guys the best videos on these topics as I can. There I'll also leave below Thorne's collagen supplement as well, to give your hair care journey an extra boost as well. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys. What are your thoughts on nutrients for hair growth? What's your experience been like with hair loss? Leave them down below. And until then, guys, watch this video I made on the top 3 hair oils for growth, and I'll see you on the next one.